God is creator of all things and has revealed in the scriptures the authentic account of his creative activity. And we believe as a church that everything we see, gimora mora mwana ne bo mchenka ochwe gi Jehovah Nyasaye. Nyaka an mabero kane and handwork ma Jehovah Nyasaye. In mibero kanyo no, you are handwork of God. God created you. Anything that your eyes can give you, the planet Earth, the heavens, all the things that you see were created by God. We know that there are theories that will tell you that man evolved from some kind of insects or animals, and it changed gradually until it became a man that we are able to see today. Those are theories. A theory is something that can be challenged. But the creation work was done by God. And therefore, in the Adventist Church, and we call upon our members that we need to accept that gimora mora uchwe gi Jehovah Nyasaye nyaka wan. Kata piny puonja taro, to kiki woge adiera mar Biblia. After the creation, when God had done his creation in a very, very perfect way, God did the creation in a very wonderful way. The creation of me and you, the creation of man. And so, man was created in God's image. And that's why we believe in the nature of man. Man was created in the image of God. Every war that we face is because the devil is trying to mislead the people of God and take away God's image, the perfect image which was put in us away so that he may give us the false image of the evil one. And so when you see somebody committing adultery today, when you see somebody killing a colleague today, when you see people doing funny things, those things that we are doing were not part and parcel of us when God created us. But because of the great controversy, the devil brought them. So this church, we recognize that there is a battle, there is a controversy, there is a war between light and darkness. There is a war between the devil and Christ, and we are the battlefield. And so, with the great controversy that came and eliminated God's image from God's creation, from God's people, heaven sat down and saying that our intention was to make man have the perfect image for good. But now that it has been removed by the devil, we must find a solution of bringing it back or taking it back to the humanity. And that brought about the ninth fundamental belief, which is the life, death, and the resurrection of Christ. It forced God to send down his son and live here as any other person and die here through a very cruel death and be buried and be resurrected, and through his life, his death, and his resurrection, we come to gain the experience of salvation that becomes the doctrine number 10. And so his life, his death, his resurrection make us know that we can understand what is called resurrection only by looking at Christ at Calvary and accepting that Christ was crucified, he was buried, but one morning he rose and he ascended, he's in heaven today. Amen. So salvation is by Christ and Christ alone. warruok en kuom Kristo kod Kristo kende. You cannot attain salvation using any other means. Not even your works, not even your generosity cannot give you salvation. Manamiyo jawer cha wero ni tich mar lweta ok dinyal chopo chik ka kidwaro kindana koteko
kata kami
wana chwer
ok ya gula eri jo
mag mana in kendi ruot. Yes. Salvation is through Christ and Christ alone. The work of your hand cannot save you. Keeping of the law cannot save you. But when you have Christ, Christ's character will be manifested in you, and you will find yourself observing all the requirements, including keeping of the Sabbath, automatically, because Christ resides in you. Not that you do it as a law or as a requirement. So we get saved by Christ. And that is the fundamental, the teaching number 10. And when somebody is saved, once you've been saved by Christ, we need to grow in Christ. Because ka Kristo oseketwa kare, to koro nyaka wadong kuom Kristo. And that brings fundamental number 11 that says growing in Christ. One who is growing in Christ will not now be influenced by the things of this world. It will not be under the captivity of the evil one. By the way, a saved Christian, one who accepts Christ as his personal savior, will not visit a magician. Ngama Kristo keto kare ok lima juoga. Ngama lima juoga en ngama poko oneno, poko experience warwok ma Kristo kelo. Poko Kristo, poko yie ki Kristo kakanya war margimane. Emumiyo kuro wuto ka juoga. Omiyo ngama Kristo se luoko girebe, koro dongo kuom Kristo, kapile kapile oyombo gige pinyni to medo sudo machiegni gi Kristo. Kaya no dhi kajuoga, oweyo dhi kajuoga. Kaya no believe ni en kochiew to neno mna jachier. Mama gima noto igni apar mokalo emo neno kawuotho mbele ne. Simu tangu chiedo min gima noto emo neno kawuotho mbele ne. En min manoto emo siku uwego na ma oseye kuom Kristo, ma Kristo bedo ne jawar ok yie kuom jomotho. Bwana sifiwe. Ito ngeyo ni jomotho nindo. A Christian who is growing in Christ, or Christians who are growing in Christ, are required to come together as a church. Because the word church is defined as the body of believers, the unity of believers. Church is the unity of believers. Kause, wadogo kuom Kristo, koro wabedo kanise mag Jehova Nyasaye. You are a church, I am a church. She is a church, he is a church. Wane kanisa mag Jehova Nyasaye. Manyaka represent kit Nyasaye. And we will believe in the church, which is believers brought together. They form a church. So, yen ko wacho muno na church, there are people who refer this structure as a church. Gimuchukane, imano kanisa. Of course, in other contexts, itie kamua warefer ni imano kanisa. But gimami yobero kanisa, and in and an. When you stop worshiping here, this building can change to any other thing. But because church members are gathering here, that's why it is called a church. When you stop gathering here and people start coming here to drink beer, it will not be called a church anymore. It will be called a bar. But it is called a church because church members are worshiping here. So it's us being a church that makes it.